Hello students, now we are concerned with semester 2 of MCOM part 1st. For semester 2, there are 4 papers of which I am concerned with. Advanced accountancy paper number 4, that is taxation. Myself, Professor Dr. V. K. Sawant, and I am concerned with teaching advanced accountancy paper number 4. Though title of paper is advanced accountancy paper 4, it contains taxation, that is very important. Though title of paper is Advanced Accountancy Paper 4, it contains only taxation. We learned about income tax, but in this paper we are going to discuss taxation. In taxation we are focusing two important aspects of taxes, namely direct tax and indirect tax. Direct tax is a tax which is levied on direct income of an assessee. Indirect tax is concerned with consumption, use, utility of the service or goods to the particular person. So firstly, we are focusing what is the syllabus of this paper. The title of paper is Advanced Accountancy Paper. Name of the program, MCOM part 1st. Title of the course, title of the subject, Advanced Accountancy Paper 4. Subtitled as Taxation. It is for semester 2. The title of paper is Advanced Accountancy Paper 4. Subtitled as Taxation. The paper code is M19204. Firstly, I am focusing what is the examination nature for this paper. This paper is concerned with taxation, though title of paper is Advanced Accountancy. There are two important components of examination. One is semester end examination and second is continuous comprehensive evaluation. For semester end examination, we may call it shortly C, and for continuous comprehensive evaluation, we may call it shortly CEE. Here, semester end examination will be held for 60 marks and continuous comprehension evaluation is taken for 40 marks. So it makes 100 marks. So 100 marks has been divided into two parts, 60 marks for semester end examination and 40 marks for continuous comprehension evaluation. The basic objectives of designing this course subject, that is Advanced Accountancy Paper 4, subtitled as Taxation. There are certain objectives which are considered while designing the syllabus of this paper. The first objective is to introduce the basic concepts of taxation. We know that tax is required to government for doing various welfare for the sake of society. In order to bring socio-economic equality, taxation plays a dominant role. The first objective is to introduce the basic concept of taxation. There are various concepts as related to taxation. In taxation, we are going to learn two aspects of taxation, that is direct tax and indirect tax. Direct tax is related to income tax. Indirect tax is related to goods and services tax, that is GST. So in this paper we are going to learn two aspects of taxes, namely income tax and GST. There are certain basic concepts in income tax, namely SEC, assessment year, previous year, person, income, agricultural income, dividend, like this. There are also certain concepts in goods and services tax, that is goods, service, GST is also classified into three parts, namely central GST, state GST, integrated GST. So supplier, consumer, these are the important concepts as related to goods and services tax. Second objective of our paper is to train the students in computation of taxable income of different business entities. Every entity is one type of organization, but we are focusing here profit-making organizations. Profit-making organizations means profit-making entities. In the present paper, we are focusing two important business entities for computation of tax, that is partnership firm and company. To introduce the students with recent development in goods and services tax, we know that goods and services tax come into force with effect from 1st July 2017. This is imposed in order to collect tax of various goods and services. So these are the objectives of our advanced accountancy paper 4, subtitled as taxation. Now we are looking syllabus of this paper. In syllabus there are 4 units. First unit is introduction to income tax. Income tax is a tax on income. If an SEC has more than 2,50,000, or in case of senior citizen 3 lakh, his income is taxable. So in our BCom part 3 part, we learned income tax, but for MCom part 1st semester 2, there are 6 important subcomponents of the introduction to income tax that we are going to learn. In unit 1, there are 6 parts. Part 1st, that is 1.1, definitions under the Income Tax Act 1961. We know that the Indian Income Tax is known as Indian Income Tax Act 1961. It is related with direct tax. This act was passed by the Parliament in the year 1961. This act actually came into force with effect from 1st April 1962. So, income tax is a tax on income. It is imposed on SEC. For this purpose, there are certain important definitions coming under income tax, like SEC, to whom may be called as SEC. This is defined in Income Tax Act. Person, assessment year, previous year, income, agriculture income, casual income, dividend, business, company, profession, profit in lieu of salary, principal officer. These are the important definitions we will discuss later on. Second part of this unit is exemptions under section 10. The Income Tax Act 1961, section 10 is concerned with exempted incomes. It means that though incomes are earned by the person, but they are not taxed. Incomes which are exempted from tax are not to be included in total income of an SEC or not taxed separately. Then, third part, deductions from gross total income under Chapter 6A. Chapter 6A is concerned with deductions. There are three types of deductions: deductions in respect of payments, deduction in respect of income, and other deductions. These deductions are covered under Section 80. So, under this section, we are going to learn various deductions allowable to an SEC from his gross total income. These deductions are deduction under Section 80C, 80CCC, 80D, 80DD, 80B, 80U, 80G, like this. 1.4, set of carry forward of losses. Past losses in case of business may be carry forward, and that we are going to discuss. E filing of returns means how to file returns. What is the procedure laid down for filing returns? That is very important. And last part of this chapter unit is online payment of tax. Which procedure is to be adopted for online payment of tax? Second unit, taxation of partnership firm. In this unit, we are focusing one type of business entity that is called as partnership firm. Firstly, we will study meaning of partnership firm, then allowable remuneration. What type of remuneration are allowable as per Section 40B? Allowable interest paid to partner, taxable income and tax liability of partnership firm. That is very important. How to calculate taxable income and how to determine tax liability of partnership firm, that we are going to learn later on. Unit number 3, taxation of company. We know that a company is an artificial person created by law. There are various types of companies. Indian company, that is called a domestic company, foreign company, public limited company, private limited company, like this. Firstly, we are going to learn definition. Then types of company. What are the types of company we are going to learn? Deduction from gross company income means which are the deduction allowable to the companies we are going to learn. And last part is computation of income of company and determination of tax liability of company on the basis of prescribed rules laid down. We know that chapter number 1, chapter number 2 and chapter number 3, that is unit number 1, unit number 2, unit number 3, these three units are related with direct tax. Direct tax, taxes are classified into two categories, direct taxes and indirect taxes. In direct tax, we are focusing income tax here. In indirect tax, we are focusing goods and services tax, that is properly known as GST. So, unit number 4, introduction to goods and services tax. Under this chapter, we are going to learn important definitions like goods, service, demand, supply, composition. These are the important definitions we are going to learn. Then we will focus what are the advantages derived from GST and what are the limitations of GST. Then classification of goods and services. Under this we may classify goods in different parts and services in different categories. Composition scheme under GST. What is the composition of GST? That will be discussed. Journal entries and ledgers. What are the journal entries passed regarding GST and what are the ledgers prepared regarding it? This is the syllabus of Advanced Accountancy Paper 2 titled and entitled as Taxation. References. These are the list of books which you may refer for additional knowledge. Student's Guide to Income Tax including GST, Singhania, well-known author. Then Income Tax Law and Practice by Prasad Bhagwati. Income Tax Law, Malhotra. Income Tax Law and Practice, Dinkar Pagare. Systematic Approach to Income Tax, Ahuja and Gupta. In addition, I have provided here certain websites which are helpful to you for getting additional knowledge. That first website is www.icai.org. Another website is www.icsi.org. These are, we know that income tax is very important source of revenue to the government, especially central government. So income tax is coming under the jurisdiction of central government. So here I am going to discuss about continuous comprehensive evaluation. In shortly, we may call it CEE. For evaluation process, 40 marks are given for CCA. These 40 marks has been divided into three components. First component is active participation in classroom and academic events. It means attendance of students in lectures. How many students concerned with attendance that can be measured? It carries your attendance, your listening lectures. Presently, because of COVID pandemic situation, we are not able to conduct different academic events, but your attendance or your listening lecture is concerned with active participation. You should listen all lectures very sincerely and regularly. Then second component of CCE is project work or practical or lab work or on the job training or seminar. Because of COVID pandemic situation, we are going to conduct seminars of students. Online seminars will be also conducted. It carries 20 marks. Assignment, interview, group discussion, study tour, field visit. It carries 15 marks. It means that 5 plus 20 plus 15 becomes 40. For getting more marks, you should be alert and you should do the work accordingly. Criteria for passing. There are two heads of our evaluation. One is C, semester end examination, and another is CEE, continuous comprehensive evaluation. Students should kindly remember that separate head of passing is given. It means for continuous internal assessment, that is continuous comprehensive evaluation, out of 40, 60 marks are essential for passing. Semester end examination, it will be conducted for 60 marks. Mostly we are going to conduct this examination on MCQ type because of pandemic situation. So out of 60, you are required to get 24 marks for passing. It means that passing is related with our performance, and minimum 40 marks are essential for passing. Instead of 35%, our is an autonomous college, so we have focused new guidelines of passing, and we determined 40 marks required for passing out of 100. But remember that separately passing is essential. Though you got 40 marks in semester end examination and you are absent for continuous internal evaluation, you will be declared as fail. So remember that there are two important components, CEE, this is separate component, and SE, that is different component. In each head, we have to pass. Otherwise, your performance is declared as fail if you are not fulfilled two criteria. So this is all about our syllabus as well as objectives, also nature of evaluation. What are the references? This is the first lecture. In first lecture, we have discussed the title of paper, Advanced Accountancy Paper 4, subtitled as Taxation. What are the objectives of this paper? What are the units covered under this paper? What are the references required for this paper? And what is the passing criteria? So friends, kindly remember that hard work is important components of our success. So you directly start study of four papers which are covered under semester 2. We are going to conduct this examination very immediately. So attend all lectures sincerely and regularly. This is important for our career development. So I am finishing my lecture here. Thank you for patiently listening.